Globally, Europe is at the forefront of leading the transition towards a more sustainable energy supply. While we have been trying to reach a target of higher percentages of renewable energy, we also have been ignoring, to a vast extent, the heating and cooling sector. Theoretically, waste heat from power plants and industry could cover the heat demands in all buildings in Europe. Strategies to address buildings and the heating and cooling supply have remained too small and ignored that there are synergies when we look at the heating and cooling sector as part of the overall energy system. We can use the district heating grid to supply waste heat from industry and power plants to nearby buildings in cities and villages. Combining energy efficiency and district heating, we would be able to replace all of the fossil fuels used in the heating and cooling sectors, while also gaining the cost effectiveness of aggregated energy systems. In Heat Roadmap Europe 4, we work together with 24 partners from industry and academia in order to provide scientific evidence and decision support for cost-effectively changing the energy supply for heating and cooling in Europe. Our study covers 14 of the largest EU countries, or 90% of the total heat demand, which is about half of the energy demand in the European Union. In Heat Roadmap Europe, we've been collecting data about the heating and cooling system in Europe. We have identified what the current energy supply of heating and cooling is in all EU countries. And we've also been modeling hour by hour the energy system in order to identify new strategies to decarbonize the heating and cooling sector. Using these findings, we've developed interactive and open access maps where you're able to identify the local heat demands and the local sources of waste heat. We're also using these data to create scenarios for the 14 countries. And in these scenarios, we're using hour-by-hour analysis of the complete energy system in order to identify the role of the heating and cooling sector in the overall transition to a low-carbon society. Our aim is to democratize the decisions we're taking on the heating and cooling sector. We provide data from the local level to the national and EU level in order to engage consultants, civil servants, policymakers in the debate about what technologies are cost-effective to decarbonize heating and cooling. The final outcome of Heat Roadmap Europe are comprehensive pathways to a complete decarbonization of our heating and cooling sectors by 2050. Cities and industries can use our tools and roadmaps to achieve higher efficiencies, drastically reduce emissions, while also reducing costs. We now know that with known technologies and an integrated approach to decarbonizing our heating and cooling sector can drastically reduce the costs for heating and cooling, while also using much more renewable energy sources. We have all of the technologies and strategies to make the transition, and hopefully Heat Roadmap Europe can show us how to get there.